This video is about curly arrows and ionic mechanisms. So there's four different types of curly arrows that you can use to describe the vast majority of organic reactions. These are nucleophilic attack, loss of a leaving group, proton transfers, and rearrangements. So an example of nucleophilic attack would be if we had, say, a bromine anion and a carbocation, and this nucleophile attacked the electrophile to give us our product. However, that's a very simple case, but another example would be the attack of a nucleophile such as an alkoxide onto a carbonyl compound. For example, an acid chloride. So this nucleophile can once again attack, but in this case, unlike the carbocation, we can't form an extra bond. We can't make a carbon with five bonds, that's against the rules. So we have to break one of the bonds that's already there, and the bond that breaks is this weak pi bond to make an intermediate. So this then gives us negative charge on that oxygen because we've pushed electrons towards it. There's our new bond to the alkoxy group and our chloride. Now, that is all that we need to show for the nucleophilic attack part of this reaction. The next step, loss of the leaving group, is what we'll go on to now. So, loss of the leaving group can be also very simple. So, it could be something like a tertiary alkyl halide losing its halogen as a halide or a leaving group to generate a carbocation. And I've deliberately chosen an example that generates a tertiary carbocation because they're particularly stable compared to other carbocations, and so this type of reaction is likely to occur. However, we can also lose a leaving group for more complex species, such as this one here that we showed in the nucleophilic attack example. So if we take that molecule or that intermediate and draw it out again, and I'll put in all the Lewis pairs on the oxygen atoms here. The lone pair of electrons on this oxygen can help kick out this chloride as a leaving group. So this step is still just loss of a leaving group, but we're going to draw a nice stable resonance structure for the generated carbonyl compound. So we lose chloride, and we get this ester, and our leaving group was chloride. Okay, proton transfers. Well, these are very similar to nucleophilic attack in many ways, but we like to keep them separate because they're really a very important class of reaction and a very important class of curly arrows to get to grips with. So an example of a proton transfer could be something like an amine being put into acidic solution. So we have H3O plus. And that amine being protonated by transfer of a proton to that nitrogen, where the nitrogen is attacking with its lone pair of electrons, and we're breaking this bond between the oxygen and the hydrogen to liberate water. So we would generate the ammonium ion and one equivalent of water. And it's important to note here that we've used that lone pair of electrons to generate this new bond, and so therefore the nitrogen no longer has a pair of electrons as a lone pair, and it now has a formal positive charge. Okay, finally, rearrangements are the last type of curly arrow that you might want to draw in an ionic mechanism. And these are most common in carbocations, but you can also have carbanion rearrangements as well. So an example might be where we generate a carbocation that's not particularly stable. So this is a secondary carbocation, and it really wants to undergo some kind of reaction that will make it more stable. And one of the things it can do is to rearrange to generate a more stable carbocation. So this pair of electrons in this sigma bond between the hydrogen and the carbon, that pair of electrons can move with the hydrogen atom to generate a new bond to this carbon that was part of the carbocation. If we follow that through, we'll have a new carbocation. And it's more stable because now it's a tertiary carbocation where the positive charge is located on this carbon here. Now it's really important to note this is not transfer of a proton. It's not H plus that's moving. It's hydrogen with its pair of electrons moving across. So this is a hydride transfer. Or put a different way, it's a rearrangement. Now, the reason why that's important is that when we show that rearrangement with hydrogen moving with its pair of electrons, that pair of electrons moving away from that carbon leaves behind a vacant p orbital that is signified by the fact that we now have a carbocation. Okay, I hope that was useful, and good luck with your studies.